member of my family was allowed to choose one place in the city that we were allowed to see. So I did some research and I found the most interesting person that I've ever come across in history that I've ever looked up. And her name was Marie Laveau, and she was known as the Voodoo Queen in the 1900s, in the 1800s in New Orleans. Now, usually when people think of voodoo, they think of little dolls with needles sticking in them, or the weird doctor guy from Princess and the Frog. But in reality, voodoo is a combination of West African culture and traditions and Catholicism. So ancientorigins.net said that priestesses and priests would pray to spirits and saints who have dominion over certain aspects of life. It was brought to the Americas through the slave trade, and it was very popular in Haiti and places like Louisiana. Marie Laveau herself was a very famous voodoo priestess. She was born on September 10th, 1801, a free woman of color in New Orleans. And in 1819, when she was 18 years old, she married Jack Paris, but he died for unknown reasons, and by her 20s, she was known in New Orleans as the Widow Paris. She became a hairdresser for wealthy white women, so she could get a lot of information through gossip, and she's kind of able to get it out there that she was a very powerful voodoo woman. So in those years, she entered a common law marriage with a man named, hang on with me, Louis-Christophe Dominique Dumény de Gambillon. It's a mouthful. She had an estimated total of 15 children in her lifetime, and only one of them lived to adulthood. During multiple yellow fever epidemics, she used knowledge of medicinal herbs and remedies to nurse patients. So that's kind of what happened before she became famous from her voodoo. Now, it's rumored that she learned from her mother, and she culminated voodoo into a very successful business in Louisiana. Now, there's a very common story down in Louisiana of a New York businessman who came down with his son. And the son was arrested for raping and murdering a Creole girl, which caused a lot of outrage in Louisiana. They wanted to hang him. And so the father went to Marie, figuring that she was the only person that could possibly save his son from death. And she decided that she would do it if he gave her his cottage right outside of Louisiana, of New Orleans, which was basically a mansion. So she did it. On the same day, she went to St. Louis Cathedral and prayed for hours on end with three guinea peppers under her tongue. And it was searing pain. She walked out and she placed the peppers in the judge's bench, in the jury box, and under the defendant's seat. The next day at the trial, she walked in and claimed that she was in favor of the son, and he was acquitted of all charges. So she had a lot of power down in New Orleans. She quit voodoo sometime in the 1860s, but she died on June 15th of 1881, and she was surrounded by her family and her grandchildren. White and black people, wealthy and poor, came to her funeral to pay respects to her. And that's her tomb right there. It's a very popular visiting destination in New Orleans. People bring offerings to her, like food and money and flowers, in hopes that they'll grant she'll grant wishes for them or give them luck. People draw trinities on her tomb. to like give spirit, her spirit like luck and respect. So she's obviously a very respected woman down there. She lived an absolutely astonishing life for a woman of color in the 1800s.